once upon a future time in a place called Stardust Bay. Counting down to adventure now. Rockets on a mission, we're on.
A story for you about one of the greatest mysteries in space racing history. 25 years ago, Falcon Fairflight challenged Swift Starlight, the fastest racer ever, to a race. The two racers carried just enough fuel to get them to the far side of the moon and back. They didn't want any extra weight to slow them down. They lifted off. They flew to the moon, nose cone and nose cone. They headed around the far side of the moon, but what happened next? No one expected. Two rockets raced around the moon, but only Falcon Fairflight reappeared and returned to Earth. That day was the last time anyone saw the famous Swift Starlight. What happened on the far side of the moon? Where did Swift go? And where is he now?
So how come you're watching all this stuff about Swift Starlight?
The new issue of the Space Racer Gazette comes out next week. Exactly 25 years since Swift Starlight disappeared. So I thought I would finally solve the mystery of what happened to him.
Everybody knows what happened to him. It's obvious. He felt so bad about being beaten that he was embarrassed to show his wings ever again.
Everybody thinks they know what happened to him, but it's just a hypothesis until there's proof.
A hypothesis?
A hypothesis. You know, a guess about what happened. It helps to have a hypothesis. That way you know what you're looking to prove.
Exactly. And no one has ever found any evidence that proves what really happened to Swift. So, as the editor-in-chief of our school news blog, I'm gonna solve the mystery of Swift Starlight's disappearance once and for all. Youngest ever graduate of Stardust Space Academy. The first space racer to make it around the moon and back to Earth in less than 8 hours. Wins race, wins many races, races Falcon Fairflight and disappears, never seen again.
Hey, Chief! Here's the photograph of Coach Pigeon for the first page, in honor of his 24th anniversary teaching at the Academy.
Let's put this picture in the layout and see how it looks. Nice shot, Hawk! You know, there's something about this picture that looks familiar.
Of course it looks familiar. We see Coach Pigeon every day.
Yeah, that must be it. And that reminds me, I have to interview Coach about Swift Starlight.
How come?
Well, I'm interviewing all the teachers. They've been around a while. They might have known Swift before he disappeared.
Good luck!
Thanks. I'm gonna need it. So far, I haven't learned anything new about Swift or the moon race.
Go, go, go! That's my starling! Nice fire!
Do you have a minute, Coach? I'm interviewing all the teachers about Swift Starlight for my article. So, did you know him?
I'm pretty busy here, Robyn. I have to, dust all these rings before the next class.
Oh, don't worry. I won't take up much of your time, Coach. So, did you know Swift Starlight?
Know him? How many people really know anyone? I came to work here after Swift disappeared. That's all I know. Gotta go back to work now. Dustin. Yeah, look at these rings.
I've never seen Coach dust the rings before. He was acting like he didn't want to talk to me.
Maybe he's hiding something.
Exactly what I thought. The question is, what? And why?
Swift was a very strong flyer and a really nice rocket. The search party spent weeks looking on the far side of the moon, thinking he may have crashed, but they found nothing.
Are you still curious about what happened to him?
As a wise rocket once said, curiosity jumbled the jet.
But, as another wise rocket once said, all research is curiosity with a purpose.
which wise rocket said that?
You did.
So what did Headmaster Crane say?
Nothing new, but he did remind me of something. Swift only had enough fuel to get back to Earth, and that got me thinking.
About what?
About where he went when he disappeared. He couldn't have flown to another planet, and nobody saw him come back to Earth. He must have landed on the moon. And there's only one way I can prove it.
What's that?
I have to go to the moon! Tonight!
Robyn, search parties explored the moon a zillion times after Swift disappeared.
We might just find something they missed.
I doubt it. But hey, I'm always up for a trip to the moon.
And if you're both going, I am too!
Okay then, let's get out of here. Booster rockets!
Engaged!
Wings!
Back!
Space visors!
Down!
Blast off!
Is it always this dark here?
We can never see this side of the moon from Earth. That's why it's called the far side. But sometimes it's dark and sometimes it's light, depending on where the sun is.
Speaking of the sun, lights on, guys. Okay, let's spread out and keep our eyes open.
What exactly are we looking for?
I'm not sure, but this is the last place where Swift was heard from. Figure there might be a clue around here somewhere. Something that nobody expected to find. Something that will change everything.
Hey, what are friends for? Robyn, Hawk, over here! Doesn't that look like an X marked in the lunar dust?
This can't be from 25 years ago. The lunar dust would have blown it away by now.
Not necessarily. There's no wind on the moon. So even though the lunar surface can change, it takes a long time. Longer than 25 years.
Maybe it's nothing.
But maybe someone wrote it there for a reason.
Well, there's only one way to find out.
Wait! There's something here!
Wow, that looks like the patch Swift Starlight used to wear. What's it doing here?
I'm not sure, but I think we're onto something. This stuff looks like it was buried on purpose.
What do we do now?
I think we should head back to school. I need to do some more research and some hard thinking. This patch is identical to the one Swift was wearing when he disappeared. It must belong to him.
But what about the can of paint? What could that have to do with Swift Starlight?
I don't know, but it was buried along with the patch. There has to be a connection.
Oh, sorry, but I'm too tired to think straight. I'm going to bed.
Me too. Coming, Robyn?
In a minute.
It's almost as if Swift Starlight got rid of the patch and then painted something. But what? Blue paint. Oh my gosh! Swift Starlight is Coach Pigeon? So no one saw you fly back to Earth, but you didn't have enough fuel to go anywhere else. So you must have disguised yourself. When we found your patch in the can of paint, I guessed what happened. After you painted yourself blue, you rolled to the Space Academy lunar base, and the rest is history.
Robyn, this is just a hypothesis. There's nothing to tie me to that patch or the can of paint.
No? What about this? Swift had a twin brother, and I've done extensive research, so I know he didn't.
Okay, you got me. I used to be Swift Starlight.
Gee, but why did you disappear? You were the best! You were so famous!
That's exactly why.
I don't understand.
First, I thought all I wanted was to win races, and I did, lots of them. But then I discovered that winning didn't make me happy. Everyone was always trying to beat me, to be better than me. It wasn't fun anymore. Even being famous got to be annoying. I couldn't go out for a cup of fuel without being chased for autographs. So instead of finishing the race, I hung back and let Fairflight get ahead of me when we hit the dark side. Then I landed. Nobody on Earth could see me there. The rest happened exactly like you figured. I gotta say, I'm impressed.
You are?
Absolutely. I fooled everyone for a long time. But you didn't just accept what everybody thought. You had a hypothesis, and then you went and found the evidence to prove it. Way to go, kid.
Gee, thanks. Oh, I can't wait to write the story. This is gonna be the scoop of the century. Coach, is something wrong?
Robyn, I need to ask you a really big favor.
Sure. What?
Please, don't write the story.
Don't write the story? But I'm a reporter. A reporter's job is to write the story.
Listen, if everyone finds out I used to be Swift Starlight, they'll never leave me alone. I'll have to leave the academy. And I love it here. I love teaching you kids. I'm much happier as Coach Pigeon than I ever was as Swift Starlight, no matter how many medals I won.
Okay, Coach. I'll keep your secret.
Tell you what. One day when I'm an old rocket, I'll let you write the story of my life.
Really? You've got a deal.
So, did you figure out what our discovery means?
Yep. It means Swift Starlight wanted to lose that race and disappear.
So where is he now?
Who knows? But I'll bet he's gone on to even greater accomplishments.